Today we're going to talk about 2.5, which is formulas and problem solving. So we're going to have some more word problems involved today. So as we talked about last time, it's really important that you are showing your steps out on your paper. You can get partial credit this way, but you can also lose credit if you're not showing work. So really important. So first thing I need to tell you for this section is this formula will be given to you on the test. I don't care if you use another formula that you have memorized, but I'm going to tell you right now, most of the time when people try to use a formula they have memorized with the decimals involved, or you notice I have a parentheses, another formula here, if they try to use a different formula, they actually use it wrong and get the whole problem wrong. So I recommend you using the formula on all your homework problems. It's on the top of the page because that's what's going to be given to you on the test. First things I want to review real quick are what we've been doing on solving equations. So I want you to remember what I've been always saying before this is clear any fractions and parentheses first. It's kind of like resetting the format. So clear fractions, clear parentheses first. Then we're going to look at what we're solving for after we've cleared the fraction. Then look at what your goal is. What do you want to solve for? This seems silly when I'm saying this, but when we get to these problems here in a second, I'm just going to shrink this a little bit, it's going to become more confusing when you have multiple variables. So this step right here, usually we just kind of are like moving with the flow. We know X is what our goal is, but when we have multiple variables, it gets confusing on what we're solving for. So I actually suggest box the variable if there's more than one variable in the problem at this stage. After that, my goal is to get my boxed by itself on one side, everything else on the other, and my last step is to get the box isolated by itself as well. So step three is using adding and subtracting to move something from the left of the equation to the right of the equation. Step four is using multiplication and division. Y'all have been doing these steps other than the box idea, but the box will help when we deal with problems like number two on this page. So just, I think it's a good idea to know that in your head. That's generally what y'all are doing anyway, but just know that we're going to add an extra step here. So going to number one, what throws a lot of people off is they don't do what I said for number one for any solving of problems. Clear your fractions, clear your parentheses right off the bat. But again, it is up to you on if you want to do that right away. I can actually just plug in right off here. So I'm going to plug in these before I actually do anything just to see if anything simplifies. So I get 180 equals 1/2. H, capital B is 11. Lowercase b is 7. And this is important. If you have upper and lowercase variables, you need to be careful when you're typing answers in. So right here, I can simplify right now inside that parentheses. So a lot of people go, oh, wait a minute, I can divide both sides by 18 right now. So I'm going to do that first. I'm going to do this problem a few different ways. So if I divide both sides by 18, I get 10 equals 1/2 h. But this is where a lot of people get thrown off. They don't know what to do. They divide by 2. If I want to get rid of this, this is a fraction. You multiply both sides by the LCD. So you multiply both sides by 2. You get 20 equals h. That's your answer. A lot of you are like, huh? Well, again, if you have a fraction, you multiply every term by the LCD. In this case, it was 2. So I'm going to go back up here and show you another way, because I want you to realize that not everybody's mind works the same. Not everybody's mind works the same as if you click the help me solve this in my math lab. So I want you to realize this is all multiplication on the right-hand side. And so I can use the commutative order and change the order and flip-flop the 18 and the h, because that doesn't change any value. Now I can multiply 18 times 1/2, which gives me a 9. And now it's super easy. Y'all can look at this and divide both sides by 9, which gives you 20. I'm showing you alternatives here so that it's your choice on what clicks in your head. You do not need to learn all of them. So the last one would be, if you started off and use this idea, I got rid of my parentheses, but I'm going to clear my fractions before I do anything else. So the key is understanding that this is all one term because it's multiplication. So I have 2 times this and 2 times this term. So I get 360 equals these 2's cancel, and I'm left with h times 18. Divide both sides by 18, and you also get h equals 20. You use which technique makes most sense to you. But what I say is clear parentheses, clear fractions first. So looking at number 2 now, this problem is one that has lots of variables. So since it has lots of variables, we are not going to go about it in our same format. We're going to first look at it. There's no parentheses, there's no fractions. So now I'm going to look at what I want to solve for. I want to solve for t. So I'm going to box it. I'm going to write this down here so that it's kind of clear what I'm looking at now. If there are no fractions, decimals, we're going to box what we want to solve for. So I want you to understand, that's my goal. My goal is to get that one by itself. So anything right now that is on that same side that is added and subtracted, because that's our next step, if you look at step 3, we need to move to the other side. So the p is being added right here, so I'm going to subtract it to move it to the other side, because we add and subtract first. Now we multiply or divide to get that t isolated, so I'm going to divide both sides by pr. Those cancel. My answer is a minus p over pr equals t. I find it super helpful if y'all box. You do not have to, but I really do think it tells your brain, this is my goal. I want to get this by itself. Clear fractions in parentheses first. Box your variable. Third step, anything added and subtracted on that side, move to the other side. Last step, anything multiplied or divided, move by multiplication and division. So going to number 3, this is a problem that you're going to see in pretty much almost any math class you take. So it's going to be a perimeter problem in some format. So I actually have learned throughout the years that a lot of people make mistakes using the formula, which is 2L plus 2W equals P. She's always going to use this in her videos and her help me solve this. Perfectly acceptable for you to use that, because the whole idea is that if I have this problem, the reason why it's 2L plus 2W is if I were to walk around, which is perimeter, I get an L plus W plus L plus W. That's where that comes from. I actually find y'all are better off drawing the picture out and labeling, because they're going to always give you a relationship so that you do not have L's and W's. So in this problem, they tell you the length is 10 meters less than twice the width. What did I say about less than in the last video? You always take it away. So L is equal to twice the width minus 10. Some of you may take an extra step and write that down first. The L is equal to twice the width minus 10. The minus is because it had a less than. So my other piece of information they give me is the perimeter is 400. So if you want to use the formula, you can go directly to the formula. I actually have found that if y'all take this and you walk, so this side would be 2W minus 10, and then I walk. I'm going to add the 10, because again, perimeter is walking. I'm going to add 2W minus 10, and then walk that last side, which is W. I want you to first realize this is the same thing as using that formula that I have in the box above, because I have 2W minus 10 and 2W minus 10, which is the length, and I have 2W's, but I find when y'all start plugging into formulas with multiplication involved as well, you make more mistakes. So at this point right now, I'm just going to add and collect my like terms. So I have 3 plus 2, which is 5, plus 1, which is 6, and I have a minus 20. So now I'm going to add 20 to both sides. 6W equals 420. W equals 420 divided by 6, which is 70. Also, just a real quick comment. I didn't mention this at the beginning. Even if you're using the other formula, if y'all watch the Help Me Solve This, they use X's. At the end, y'all aren't really sure what you just got. So that's why for this type of problem, I use L and W, because I know right now my width is 70 because I got W equals. So looking at this, my width is 70 meters. Going over to this piece over here, my length is 2 times 70 minus 10. That's 140 minus 10, which is 130 meters. There's no confusion if you do this. So just an alternative, if you draw the picture out, perimeter's always walking around. For a lot of you, that is actually easier to do than to use her format, which is totally correct using the formula shortcut. So going to number 4, and again, at any time you need to pause and rewind, do that. So again, this is the formula, and I want to stress this. You're going to have more types of problems, but I'm showing you the problem that we're going to tend to get confused on, and y'all are going to want to use the other formula for. They give me Fahrenheit. So 77 is my Fahrenheit. And so what I need to do now is I can do multiple things. I can collect like terms, which is what most of y'all will do. I can clear fractions, so I'm going to show it both ways. So I'm going to subtract 32. These cancel. We get 45 equals 9/5 times C. Some of you realize that you can multiply by the reciprocal here to clear it. I actually am still going to just use the idea and do this in two steps. I'm going to multiply by the LCD to get rid of it. This is going to give me 45 times 5 would give me, again, you can use your calculator, 225. And so I get 225 equals 9C, divide both sides by 9, and I get 25 degrees is my answer of Celsius. So that's if you wanted to deal with that piece of keeping the fraction on that first step. If you wanted to multiply everything on this first step times 5 to get rid of it, and remember it's every single term, so underline if you need to. So 77 times 5, if you put it in your calculator, will be 385. The 5 cancels for my second term, and 32 times 5 gives me 160. So difference here is I multiplied and cleared them first completely on the left-hand side. When I did it, I moved everything together before I cleared them. So subtract the 160 from both sides. This gives me 225 equals 9C, which is the same thing I have on the left-hand side. Divide by 9, and I get C equals 25 degrees. So your choice on clearing the fractions at the beginning, middle, or end.